Okay, now that I showed you how to make mud flaps, I'm gonna show you how to make toolboxes. Like, for the back of your truck. Say if you have a stack. If you have a stack, you want it behind the stack. Oh, these are tires I just glued together. They're Dodge and one from this trailer. One from this trailer, which I swapped over to, and I glued one right there for act like a spare, because it's my pulling tractor trailer, which it's gonna be my pulling truck trailer once I get my pulling truck that I'm gonna be making. Okay, so do I have a pen? Okay, I'll be right back once I get a pen. Okay, I got a pencil, and one thing while making your toolboxes, do not guess. That's one thing my friend does a lot, is just guess. So, I'm going to take my truck. I'm going to mark off where it needs to be cut. Then I'm going to take my snippers, grab onto the wood, popsicle stick. Then you're going to want to just cut it. This is the longer piece. This is the piece that just goes across your bed. And you're probably saying, well, you don't just want a piece of wood just sitting across your bed of your truck. So you're going to get another piece, and you're going to want to measure, kind of. You want to go have this edge right at the edge of your bed on the inside. And you're going to mark it about a little bit inside your bed. So it's going to be cut with your snippers right where that cut should be made. That's why you have the pencil. You should not be guessing. And then you want to put the other one on top of this one. Then it's make sure it looks good. And if you have to, and I probably would, put another piece right underneath it. Just to make sure it looks more like a toolbox. It just makes it look a little better. So yeah, I'm going to put another piece underneath it. So I'm just going to cut one piece to cut the same size as that one. And I have my three pieces. I'm going to move my truck further back so I can get the pieces of wood. So you're saying, okay, so how do you put this in your bed? First, you gotta glue them all together. So first, I'm gonna get my epoxy glue. Not really. So then I'm gonna slide a little bit on there. I'm gonna get this piece, and we're just gonna kinda put it on. And then center it, and then give it a push. And hold it down for a couple seconds. Then I'm going to get your other piece. And then I'm going to put glue on this piece. Then I'm going to put this, the little piece of popsicle stick, on that. So then, you're just going to let this dry for a little bit. Mostly better to use super glue for this, for all of these. So, I'm gonna let that dry for a couple seconds while I talk to you. Okay, so the mud flaps on this truck, that's the kind I wanted to turn out. And this tire rack. This is one tutorial, too. Except this is mostly just gonna be the tire racks, all you do is simple. Get a bunch of tires and just glue them together. And so if you see some shiny part, that's glue to hold it together, because I'm going to have that just sitting in the back of my truck when I pull my pulling truck, which is going to be a 2012 Dodge 2500 with duals in the back. I already got the tires ready, so then I just need the truck, which will be here in about. And I just ordered a first gen, like Bandit Boys. And Bandit Boy, if you're watching this, any tips on that grill you made for the first gen? I do not have any basswood wood left, so I have some basswood, but I don't really think that'll work. Okay, so I have this silver marker, and you can use paint. I'm not going to use paint for this, and then you just... Just put it on. Then you can glue this into your bed. But I'm not going to. Yes, I'm going to wait to finish this till it dries. And you pretty much just cover the rest of it in silver. And that's how you make a 1/64 scale toolbox. There will be one more video, which will be a running board video. In about 30 minutes. Okay, so this is Full Custom Garage signing out.